Hey, I'm Grace.
And I'm Ava.
And we just wanted to dedicate this night to Emma, and because she touched all of us and she was our best friend, and we wanted to show her love and how much people loved her around here and how many people loved her and, you know, who she really touched. And so throughout the night, everything is going to be recorded, songs, paintings, videos and interviews of people can say anything they want to say, and you know, just a positive, awesome memory of them and Emma. So hope it's gonna be a good night.
Monday. So good to me. Monday morning, it was all.
Well, Emma was my first yoga student ever when I started teaching, and she was the one who started to convince me to expand my classes and reach out, even though, like, I was really nervous too. And every time I was teaching, whenever I glanced over at Emma, she'd always have just, like, the biggest smile on her face, completely supporting me, just like smiling because she knew we were gonna like leave yoga afterwards and just like laugh and do my hair. She wrapped my hair, and she was just such a friend to everyone who knew her, and just an old soul and a beautiful, beautiful person who made you feel comfortable within seconds and made you feel like you'd be friends forever. And she will be truly, truly missed.
Monday, how could you leave and not take me? Every other day of the week is fine, yeah. But whenever Monday comes, you can find me crying all of the time. Monday.
And we were all in the auditorium thing in the commons, and they started playing twerking music, and this guy ran out on stage and started twerking. And then he was like, who wants to do a twerking competition with me? And then Emma just like jumped up and ran up on stage and started twerking with him. And needless to say, she won, but then I met her because during orientation we all stayed in Brandt, and she was on my floor, and I was like, nice twerking, and she was like, thanks, I'm just trying to have fun, you know? And I was like, yeah, and that's how we became friends.
It just turns out that way. Well, I ain't nobody.
So, our last memory, we were getting Subway together, and I was having a very bad day. And then we were walking back to Johnson's dorm, and then we saw someone in the distance hula hooping in Monroe Park at night.
Who's this?
And like, who in their right mind would be hula hooping in Monroe Park by themselves?
At night.
And then we get there, and then it's Emma, like, Emma, like, what are you doing? And she's like, oh, my friends just like made me a hula hoop, and I thought I'd learn some new tricks.
So. Yeah, and I happen to know some hula hoop tricks, so I was like, I'll show you some. And we were all just kind of like laughing and like trying different things. And it was just like a really happy memory, and she just seemed like so full of life.
like brightened up my day so much. And just like, it was like the perfect, like looking back on it, it was like the perfect way to like remember her.
I think it was her essence. And once we left, she just kept on going.
She just kept going by herself in Royal Park, blue hooping. But honey, it feels right.
Dress, this plain green dress, and she was like, I love it so much, like you totally rock that. And I just remember I felt so good by her saying that, like I just, the whole night I kept thinking about it because her opinion mattered so much to me. And later that night also, we were like walking down the street and she saw me again and she was just like, you're my girl crush. And I felt so special, like she was a person that made me just feel so special.
My fondest memory of Emma is her good vibes is always do this motion, eyebrows like this across the room to me, and it was just a nice reassurance that everything was alright. I really liked it. I kind of miss it.
was at the block party at the first week of school. We had gotten food together and it was just me and her sitting there. Grace had left at that point. We had all been talking together. And she was talking to me about glass art and how she was interested in it. And I connected with that because like my family, they're all like a bunch of glass artists. So I thought it was really neat. And we're both like vegetarians and vegans. We connected on that level. And just like ever since then, I would see her around like at parties or at Johnson or on the street. And she would just like come up to you and say, "Hey, how are you?" And she'd just give you this big smile. And it would just like brighten up your day. Just every time you saw her, you just felt 1,000 times better than you did if you were having a bad day. She'd smile at you and you'd just feel really special and happy. And that was just Emma. That's how she was every day. And I'm gonna miss her a lot.
My favorite thing about Emma is every time she enters the room, like, light up the room with energy, ignites a feeling of well-being and like comfort. And she would just make everyone feel like at home. And she made you feel like you were in the right place at that time. She made you feel good about what you're saying, no matter what. She passed no judgment, Nothing bad is in that. Ain't nobody proud.
Friend and I were just sitting outside on the compass. We were just like sitting there, and for some reason we just started talking about how like a lot of animals are just attracted to us, and like for me especially, like insects. And so, and then like Emma just all of a sudden just like rolls in on her bike, and then she just like hops up. She's like, "Hey guys, what's up?" And like nothing much, just talking about like how these animals are like really, really like they love us, I guess. And she's like, "Yeah, that happens to me a lot, but for some reason it's always like flies. And they just like sit on my hand." And she's like, "Man, it must have been a pretty filthy." She's just like, it was so funny. And then we're like, "I guess it does, but same thing happens to me." And then she just like hopped on. She's like, "See you guys later." So yeah, I thought that was very never ever saw the stars so bright. In the promise, things will be alright, 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 alright. My best Emma memory was being on a walk back from our house after a yoga class at Macy's. I was carrying my longboard, and Emma mentioned something like she wanted to ride and try it out. And so I was pretty shocked at this. Most girls don't really do that. And so like I was asked her again if she wanted to, and she was like, "Yeah, I really do." And so I handed her the longboard, and she just hopped on the board with like no fear, no hesitation whatsoever. And when she was like coasting along, she like looked back and gave me the best smile I've ever seen. I never ever saw the northern lights. I never really heard of cluster flies. Never ever saw the stars so bright. In the front I says we'll be alright.
My favorite Emma memory, I don't know, we played music a lot, so that was like some of the most cherished memories. But one time in particular, I had a didgeridoo, and she was like, "Oh my god, really?" And her eyes just lit up. So I brought it to Richmond, and we went to the park one day, and I tried to teach her how to play it, and she got one little toot out, and her little eyes lit up, and she's just so stoked on that. I thought that was fun because she's got such a kick out of small things like that. Yeah, and I thought that was really